WBRI 1500 in Indianapolis.
The Martin Bender Band Share Show.
It was death that passed through into all mankind. It was death. I've been thinking about this all night.
Are you sure it wasn't a White Castle hamburger?
No, it wasn't a White Castle hamburger. That's you. You're the White Castle hamburger.
I hate White Castle. It'll pass through, you know.
Who needs White Castle?
White Castle.
It's the grossest thing in the world. I don't know how anybody can eat that crap.
White Castle passes through all mankind. Trust me.
You see, they try to make it look good on their signs. I drive past the White, and all it is two fluffy pieces of enriched white bread and this little crappy piece of whatever in between the bread. I don't know.
If Shania Twain and Alyssa Milano and Brooke Shields were holding a White Castle hamburger, it would still look gross.
I would avert my eye.
I
would make a pact with my eyes.
Exactly.
Not to look at a White Castle hamburger. I don't care who's holding it. I didn't even care if Mrs. Taft was holding it.
Mrs. Taft.
I wouldn't even.
Woo!
I'm telling you, and that's hard to turn away from. Mrs. Taft. She had that waist hip ratio thing going.
Oh, my goodness.
You know, she had the narrow waist, and William Howard did not have the waist-hip ratio thing going on.
I don't know. Something about William Howard, though.
There's something about him that reminds me of a bathtub. What is that?
I don't know. I don't want to get into that. But for
more
details about Mrs. Taft, just read the song of Solomon. That's all you need to know.
For more information.
Yeah. I hope people don't get squeamish when they hear us talk like this, because God talks like this in the Bible, so.
He does. He talks about White Castle hamburgers
Melissa.
What's her name? Alyssa Milano. Is that her name?
Yeah.
We seem to talk about her a lot, and when we're off.
There's a context to that, Martin. Come on,
I'm sorry.
All right, where are we?
Becky Sheridan, turn this radio off right now.
She knows I love her more than anything.
That's right. She's a beautiful woman. You're right.
I know.
Becky Sheridan, yeah.
No one's seen her. That's why I mentioned the other ones. If she was a popular TV star, I'd mention her.
That's right. That's why you mentioned it in the first place.
Exactly.
Right. I'll go to Romans 5, because I've been thinking about this
all
night.
What were we talking about again?
We're talking about death passed through, and then you brought up White Castle hamburgers.
No, we were talking about why our scriptures are better than
anything. Yeah, and then we talked about death, and the reason our scriptures are better is because...
Better than what?
These other scriptures of these other major religions.
Right.
The Tripitaka and whatever.
The Vedas and the Shastas and the Quran and all the rest.
Yeah, the thing they have in common, all of them, is a continuous existence. And we say that, our scriptures are better because we treat death as death. That sounds kind of strange to say that. Why is your scripture better? Because you die. Because you really die. That's why our scriptures are better. Well,
right.
People, what? That doesn't appeal to man. Man doesn't want to die because death is the scariest thing in the world.
Right.
And so who wouldn't embrace a religion that says, you won't die?
Right.
Don't believe God. Did God say you're going to die?
No.
You won't die.
You're not going to die.
Oh, really? I'm not going to die? I'm not going to be stripped of my soul and have the spirit removed from me and lay in a grave and rot? Any religion that tells me I'm not going to die, no wonder they're popular.
Mm-hmm.
No wonder. And guess who has jumped on the popularity float?
The Christian
religion has jumped on the popularity float.
Modern Christianity has borrowed its theology from false religions, from Dante and Plato. And the teaching of Christendom today regarding death is a satanic lie.
That's where it started, in the Garden of Eden.
It started in the Garden of Eden, and this is a hard thing, and people aren't going to like hearing this. We stand on the sacred scriptures here, not on degenerate theology. Not on degenerate theology that comes from Greek philosophy and from false religion that began shortly after began with Paul in Paul's day, and especially after his departure from the scene.
Well, actually, it began in the Garden of Eden.
You're
right. Satan. I mean,
exactly.
But it flourishes at different points in time. We see a resurgence of the lie that thou shalt not surely die. But this is a huge point that all religion can trace its source to the first lie of Satan, thou shalt not surely die.
Yeah.
And death is the centerpiece. And before you go on that, you're going to go to, I don't know,
where you're going to go.
I'm in Romans 5:12. You ended with this yesterday. Speaking of, let's see. Oh, I got a hole in my, I got a rip in this page right here. I can't even read my. Therefore, at, in 12 of Romans 5, as through one man sin entered the world, and through sin death, thus death passed through into all mankind, on which all sinned. Mm-hmm. That sounds pretty confusing, but to put it in.
And by the way, layman's this is terms, the only translation that gets it right.
Yes, it gets it right, because most translations give you the idea that...
No, let's lay the cards on the table face up. All most right. translation bring their theology into the scriptures and they don't translate it right because right. they don't understand this topic.
Right. It's death. It's death is passed through into all mankind. We inherit something from
on
Adam.
On which yes. all sinned.
And, no, I was taught in a Catholic church that you've ever heard the phrase the dirty birth?
Yeah.
You know, that always, my dad hated that truth. That's why he rejected anything about God. He thought, well, how terrible that we're born a poor little innocent baby.
Original sin,
yeah. Dirty birth is born a sinner. But now, this is going to sound wrong, but technically that's not true.
Mm-hmm.
You're not born a sinner. I dropped the bomb.
You sure did. Why don't you finish that?
I better finish it fast before they're pulling the plug on it. Duke's pulling the plug. Here's yeah. the... All right. It's death. This is what the Word of God says. Thus death passed through into all mankind. I'm going to read the rest of it, but I'm going to stop there.
Yeah.
Death is what we inherit.
Yep.
Now, Adam was the first one who sinned first, and then he died.
Yes.
Or then he became mortal.
Right.
Adam sinned, then he became mortal.